She's a prayer warrior, down on her knees, wrestling with power and principalities, standing in the gap for others, for her sisters and...
Thank you for joining us back. We are still continuing to know more about flesh. We have been ignorant for a period of time about the flesh, but it's important. Why did God give us the flesh? That is the topic we have been having together with my friend, my brother, Prophet Shiloya. Thank you very much. Such an impact. And you're impacting life outside there. They are getting to know about why flesh. And the spirit at the same time. And this, the God promise, apart from now the eternal life that Jesus died, they are also the God's promise.
Actually, I don't want to call it a promise. I want to call it a covenant.
Okay.
Because a covenant is an agreement between two parties. And the promise that is behind a covenant, it has rules that until you fulfill your part, the results is painting, and God is telling Moses, God is telling his children from Israel, from Egypt, that if only you can serve me, if only you can serve me, if only you can commit yourself to the advancement of the kingdom, to seeking first the kingdom, and then I'll bless your water, I'll bless your bread. And that tells you something very, very deep. If you can allow me, I can just go somehow deep.
Yes.
That until today, we should not lose the understanding that human beings are still coming from the ground. We have a deep connection with the ground. Because the food that we eat that comes from ground has a lot to do on human support, on human life. And that is where the energy is derived from. When even talk about conception, it's all about what you feed, what you eat, and a lot to do with food. So when God is telling you that I'll bless your water and I'll bless your bread, God is telling you that you can have water, but as long as it is not blessed by me, it is not good for your flesh. You can have bread in plenty, but as long as it does not have my blessing, it does not glorify me. You can eat it and die. The other day, the woman said to Elijah that I only have a small cake that I and my son will eat and die. So in the presence of the small food she had already seen a vision that even after they finish eating, they will die. But a prophet who was there to represent God, who blesses bread and water, he said that if you can give it to me, you shall not die. So you can have bread, you can have plenty of water, plenty of food in terms of finances. You can have a lot of money that is not blessed. You can have a lot of food that is not blessed. But if you can serve God, if you can serve God, I'll bless your water and I'll bless your bread. And if only you can have that understanding, and that one is spiritually connecting us to Holy Communion, that I will talk about it later. That if you can if you can be eating blessed bread and be drinking blessed water, and then sickness from you is forbidden all the days of your life.
Completely.
Completely.
And now talking about John 15 verse 2 that says, every branch in me that beareth not the fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth it away, that it may bring forth more fruit.
Very true. It has on different perceptions.
Okay.
That even, I like giving my examples by even the governments we have today, that authorities are put by God, and we shall know them by their own fruits. If there comes an individual whose pleasure is to disturb people's peace, breaking people's houses, limiting are limiting children to have their school, to have their constitutional rights. Mm. The government has God's backup when they kill such a person.
Yes,
because that is a person that is not bearing good fruits for the nation. Mm. And God is saying that if there be anyone who will not bear fruits, who will not bear fruit, he has no mandate of living. Why will you be living for? That will be cut off. But if there be a branch in me that will bear fruit, why will it not be taken care of to have many years to live so that it can continue bearing fruits to the family, to the nation, and to the whole world at large?
Wow, so nothing that does not bear fruit is supposed to be in our flesh.
Nothing. Completely nothing absolute. Nothing that puts you on a, anything that puts you on a profitless living is not godly.
Okay. And now I want to go back to the book of Jeremiah, the God of all flesh. Mm. And we are seeing the same repeated in the book of John. First John 14.
Sure.
And the word became flesh.
And the word became flesh.
Uh-huh. Can you try to connect us?
That's what Jesus is telling us, that I am a true vine. Mm. I am the true vine. Mm. And ye are supposed to be branches. Mm. Now, John is telling us that Jesus is not just a common person. Mm. No, he's not just a son of a carpenter. Mm. He is a word that became flesh. In the beginning, there was word. Mm. And this word was just in existing without flesh. Mm. And for that word to manifest into physicality, it became flesh. And you will find the scripture saying that it was of him as it was written about him. Mm. Meaning that we are flesh, there is what is written of us. Mm. We should become the word. As the word became flesh in Jesus' life, we should make that word manifest in our life. Manifest in our life. Making every, having the understanding of where your leg stands in the Bible,
yeah,
where your hand stands in the Bible, where your eye stands in the word of God, and convert it consciously into becoming a word that has been transformed into a flesh. Because the Bible will also tell you that everything will pass away, but only the word of God will stand. So any flesh that will be minus the word of God, it will perish.
And now that one is giving me that, like, you know, also the word says that we eat the flesh, the word.
Mm.
And that means your flesh, everything, every part of you, if it's cut, let the word come out of that. That means that anything that wants to plant itself in the flesh, it won't.
Very true. The reason why God is picturing this unto us, that our lives, our flesh, should be totally his word. That even if you have to penetrate deep into your flesh, what you should only see, you should only see the glory of God.
Yes.
That whatsoever cannot withstand the word of God, it should not withstand your presence. Because you and the word of God, there should not be a difference. Because the word of God brings light on the feet of the righteous person. So anywhere a righteous person will move, his presence should always see, should always manifest the presence of God. So whatsoever cannot stand a test of the word of God, whenever you appear, whenever you avail yourself, that thing should always scatter. The book of Psalm 68 that says, let God arise and let his enemies be scattered. So wherever you arise, because there is a word inside you, because there is a word inside your flesh, all the enemies of God should flee from your presence.
And in case your flesh is attacked, just like the way maybe you go and see a doctor, what are the prescriptions of the flesh?
Yes, doctors are also fulfilling a calling of protecting lives.
Mm.
And I am in no way undermining the good work they are doing.
Mm.
And that's why if we have environments where we have no hospitals, we lament a lot and we pray that they should have one.
Mm.
But that does not limit your understanding that you should serve the God of all flesh.
Mm.
God has given us options.
Mm.
That believe in me and live a life of no trouble, your flesh will not be attacked. Mm-hmm. But have a little understanding. First Peter 3, the Bible says that by his divine power he has given us all things that we need pertaining to godliness, mm-hmm. that through the knowledge of him. So through the gates of knowledge, mm-hmm. if you don't have the knowledge of him, don't die. Mm-hmm. Go to the hospital, mm-hmm. be given medications, mm-hmm. and you get healed, it's okay with you. But if you want the divine one, mm. because personally there are people who have come to my ministration, mm. they have gone to the hospital, the hospitals have carried out all the necessaries and nothing is being found. Mm. And when they come to the anointing, mm. you find that they are relieved and they are free. Mm. That tells you that you cannot underestimate the knowledge of God on the flesh, because it is the final say. Doctors may treat, but they don't heal.
Very true. Now I want you to give us this prescription, like the Holy Spirit, blood of Jesus.
I will start it from the Word of God.
Okay.
That the Word of God carries the Spirit of God.
Mm.
The Spirit of God carries the anointing of God.
Mm.
The anointing of God carries healing and deliverance, mm. which we call breaking the yoke.
Mm.
By the reason of the anointing, the yoke shall be broken.
Mm.
So it has to start from... it has to start from the Word of God,
mm-hmm.
and then you will come to the rules of engagement, where you will find the witnesses of God on the ground, which is water,
mm-hmm.
Blood, and the Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
And by having that understanding of the Word, mm-hmm. that His blood mm-hmm. is the source of life.
Yes.
His blood. Okay, this is the law of life, mm-hmm. that the life of the flesh mm-hmm. is in the blood.
Okay.
You lose blood, you are losing life. You lose blood, you lose life.
Mm.
There are women who have died because of a bleeding.
Yes.
Because life, it is in the blood.
Mm.
And that is how Christ's blood carries life to us.
Mm.
So whatsoever you drink, having converted it into the blood of Christ by faith, you are not drinking the ordinary drink.
Mm.
What you are drinking is the life of Christ.
Mm.
And once it enters in you, mm. it's called Zoe, living the life as Christ has it in heavenly places.
Mm. Nice and great. I want you to talk about a little bit about the blood of Jesus. It's so powerful.
Mm.
Addressing that coming as we wind up.
Wonderful people, is that the spiritual battle is won by spiritual devices. And blood of Jesus is one of the weapons. Dangerous weapon that is feared in the spiritual realms of war. They won the battle by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. When we talk about the blood of Jesus, we are talking about the blood that speaks life. No wonder Hebrews say that his blood speaks better things than that of Abel. The blood of Abel is the blood of our family members, our family lineage, the blood that speaks limitation, the blood that speaks family patterns, because we can have flesh that is working on the patterns that are laid there. If there is a cancer in the family, you find that everybody is suffering from the same. If there is fibroids in the family, you find every woman is suffering the same. If there is asthma, you find that even to an extent, people will say that this is our family disease, because everybody in this family must have it. That is the blood of your family. But the blood of Jesus is the blood that speaks contrary to the pattern of your household. The blood of Jesus, it was not shed because he has offended anybody. It was shed that you and I may, that we may have a center where we can be washed and we can be rebirthed to a life of no infirmity, to a life of spiritual energy, to a life that we are guaranteed and immune from every attacks of the devil to our flesh.
We want to pray for our viewer, and our guest will help us to pray for them.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I thank you for each and everyone that is connected to this program. Lord, as you have said in your word, that if we will hearken to your voice and serve you, you shall bless the water and the bread. Lord, let every water, let every bread in the household of the viewers receive a mighty blessing. Let that sickness and let that infirmity that has defied the doctor's attention
mm-hmm.
receive a divine touch from this moment.
Mm-hmm.
In the mighty name of Jesus,
mm-hmm.
I cover with the blood of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much, viewer. We have come to the end of the program today.
Amen.
I hope you will be blessed.
Amen.
And keep your comments coming. They will encourage us and we keep on with the good work that I know we are helping many. We have come even to the end of the series of the healing. We were talking about the flesh. Mm. We wanted to know the root cause of the diseases and the sicknesses. Mm. If you have not been with us, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel, Champions TV Kenya. And also you can follow our Facebook account, Champions TV Kenya, and also our Twitter handle, Champions TV Kenya. Thank you very much. Next time, I promise good things are coming on the way. Keep on tuning to Champions TV every Saturday, 6:30 to 7 p.m. And know that you are prayer warrior because you are watching Prayer Warriors. Till next time, I am your host, Susan Gedeji, for now. Bye-bye. She's a